Hey kids, welcome back to Clean Slate Farm. Today, we're gonna turn this into ravioli. And we're not gonna use pasta dough, we're gonna use wonton wrappers. All right, so the first thing I have to do to get this going is I'm gonna score these. Be careful not to chop your fingers off. I'm gonna score these so that as they roast, it opens up a little bit and it'll roast a little bit faster. And then I'm going to season it with a little bit of salt and pepper. I should go get my pan. Put them on the pan. Helps. Okay, now we're going to season it. A little pepper, a little salt, and a little bit of nutmeg. Not too much nutmeg, just a little. We don't want an awful lot of nutmeg taste. These are going to be ravioli, and what I'm going to do is use ricotta cheese, a little bit of cinnamon. I got to go light on the cinnamon. I don't really like cinnamon. Ricotta cheese is going to be mixed with this, a little salt, pepper, ricotta cheese. We're going to mix this up into a filling, and then we're going to use the wonton wrappers, wrap them up, instant raviolis. No pasta dough making. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is just add a little bit of water to the pan. It's going to help steam them as well. A little bit in the bottom. Some aluminium foil, as the Brits like to say. This is a 425 degree oven. These are going to go in and they will roast 30 minutes or so. What you want to do is when you check to see how they're done is just take a fork or a knife and stick it inside. If it's nice and soft like squash is supposed to be, then you're done. Okay, let's check them. It has been about 30 minutes. So, all right, our squash is all roasted. So now what I'm gonna do is just scoop this out, follow the flesh, get rid of some of that water that's in there. Scoop the flesh out, and it's gonna pop right. Pop right out. Something got stuck in there. And this squash was about 1¾ to 2 pounds. And then what we're gonna do is, here's what we've got going on. I've got about 3/4 to a cup of grated Parmesan cheese. Feta sounds fun, so I'm gonna put some feta in there. That's maybe 1/4 of a cup of feta. Now here's the thing when you're making this. I'm using feta, so I'm not gonna add any additional salt. I've got the cinnamon and the nutmeg out. When I taste this, I wanna see what it tastes like. If I need a little bit more cinnamon, nutmeg, I'll add it. Same with the ground pepper. But the beauty about one of these is that it's whatever you wanna make it. Use your imagination. Again, the squash should be about 1¾ pounds or so, 2 pounds. I've got something stuck in my throat. And you wanna make sure you get all the skin off of there. I got some skin stuck on there, get rid of that. Peel through that. And then we're gonna mix everything in. So let me take care of this, and we'll be back in a minute. Okay, we've got just about all the squash out of that. This is compost pile. And we'll get rid of this. I'm gonna use the food processor for this because it's gonna make it go a lot faster. I better wash my hands. It's gonna go a lot faster if I use the food processor. You can mash it up as well. Now, again, I'm gonna use here, not again, but I'm gonna use ricotta cheese. And what I'm gonna look for is a mixture that's kind of scoopable, but not too scoopable. Get another spoon out here. Get our squash in there. And all over everything else. No additional water, just what we got. So let's give this a little pulsing action here. And that looks good. Now we're gonna add this, which is the feta. I'm gonna add this, pulse it a little bit more, blend that together. Now I think I'm going to take this back out and mix the ricotta in by hand. So move that over there. Hey, look at that. Bye-bye. Get our big spoon out again. So this, you'll be able to see the consistency that I'm looking for here. Stir it up a little bit. Now that's a little loose. Maybe not. It'll be fine. Get another spoon. And what I want to do is add about, I'm going to start with a quarter cup and mix that in. I got stuff flying all over the place here. Now what we're going to do is taste it. Actually, I could use a little bit more salt, maybe a little more cinnamon, nutmeg, salt. Now, salt is something where you want to not to taste the salt. You just want to taste what the salt does to the food, and it should just brighten the flavor a little bit and make it taste like what you think it should taste like. That's that. Got that. Tad more nutmeg. We should be done. Yeah, that's good. That's going to be tasty. Okay, let's get our wonton wrappers out. Start making ravioli. Alrighty, here we go. Wonton wrappers. Now, these are Nasoya wonton wrappers. And all you're going to do, wet the edge, just like you would for pasta, so that it seals. Take about a tablespoon, about that much, right in the center. Not too much. Need a towel. Take your other wonton wrapper and put it over the top. Now try to avoid getting a crimped edge. So just work your way around like this. And there you go. Lift it up. Squeeze it all the way around the edge good. We'll do a couple more so you see what this is like here. Get a close up too. There you go, ravioli. Now I'm just going to cover that up with a towel so you don't dry out too much. Try another one here. A little water along the edge. Like so. A little bit of filling. Now I'm going to have an awful lot of filling left over here. And what I'll do with that is I'll just freeze it. Use it later. Watch how I do this. Just get the edges down. Try not to get any crimps in it. But at the same time, you want to get the air out. That's what I'm doing there. Now I'll just lift it up. Work my way around. There you go. Ravioli. Okay, so we made ravioli. Now let's make tortellini. Same process. Wet all the edges. And tortellini is also, I'm not sure what that tortellini means, but it's sometimes called the bishop's hat, and you'll see why. I'm going to pick that up, corner to corner, fold down the edge, fold down the edge. Now you got that. Wet one side, bring this around, and crimp it. Now you have tortellini. Now you see why they call it the bishop's hat. It looks like the bishop's hat. Right, let's get some in there. Now this one, you see the edge is wrinkled. That's probably going to burst on me, but we'll give it a shot. Just slide them in. The water's going to stop boiling. I'm not salting the water at all. There, you made a triangle ravioli, huh? We'll throw in a couple of these tortellinis as well. You know, I like to think that every culture has its own form of pasta And the Polish have pierogi, which is made similar to this. The Asians have potstickers, which is similar to this. We're gonna let these go for about 3 minutes. So the food is what brings everybody together. Everybody's got similar food. Let them go for a few minutes and we're good to go. Take them out. Let them drain, separate them a little bit so they don't stick together as they dry. Nothing broke. That one broke. Put that one over to the side. You don't want to let them go too long, that another one broke. See, I let them go a little too long. A couple of them broke. Lost the filling. So while I was doing that, why I let it go too long was, I got this going. A little sage brown butter. Take a couple of these babies. Put them in here. Put some sage and brown butter sauce on them. Kill the burner. Go try some pasta. All right, let's see what they taste like. Now, I let the butter get a little too burned, but that's okay. Now, again, this isn't the ravioli, but kind of like cheetah raviolis. Let's see what it tastes like. Yeah, I could get used to that real well. Real easy. That's tasty. Now, the texture of the dough is different, obviously, than it would be if it were true pasta dough. But for a quick and easy meal, when you don't want to make pasta dough, this is it. Can't beat it. So, do a little recap here. You have wonton wrappers, roasted squash. Now, this is a little soupier than I want it to be, so I'm going to drain this a little bit. Wonton wrappers, cinnamon, nutmeg, salt, pepper, Parmesan cheese. I put some feta in there, and I'm tasting little bits of feta. But boy, is that feeling delicious. A little bit of salt. I added a little bit of salt and some more pepper, and off you go. There you have it. How to make ravioli with wonton wrappers and roasted butternut squash. Hey, thanks for watching Clean Slate Farm. I really appreciate it. Thumbs up. Subscribe, please. Thumbs up. Subscribe, and that's all we have from Clean Slate Farm. Thanks. Bye-bye.